Hi, I'm Drew Klaber with Mitutoyo America Corporation. I'm here with Jeremy Banks, and on today's tool tip, we're going to be discussing how to measure large work pieces using the semi-float option on a linear height gauge.
So Drew, I have some customers that use a linear height, and usually they measure small work pieces.
Right.
And when they measure the piece, maybe using a circle measurement or an arc measurement, they'll move the part so they can do the scan. But they also have the need to measure larger parts.
Okay.
And these larger parts are kind of unwieldy. They're not as easy to move as the little pieces, so they're going to move the gauge instead.
Sure.
Now, we have the float function that allows the gauge to move easily and smoothly.
Correct.
But it's also a little less accurate. And the whole reason that, you know, they have the linear height is for the accuracy.
Absolutely.
So how can I measure a large part like this for maybe one of these little internal radii the best way?
It's a great question. So you're correct that you don't want to use the compressor for when you're taking measurements, right? This is just for positioning only.
Right.
And so you're not going to get accurate measurements. But as you mentioned, sometimes your workpiece is too large that it's not feasible to move that for the measurement.
Mm-hmm.
So fortunately, we do have an in-between setting that's called semi-float. And what that will allow you to do is to use a controlled amount of compressed air so that you can still move the height gauge for the measurement. It's not as much as it would use if you were to press the button to move the compressor. But it's, as I mentioned, a controlled amount so that you can still easily move the height gauge and maintain the same accuracy that you would be that you would have as if you were moving the workpiece instead of the height gauge.
Well, that's great, Drew. Do you think you could take a couple minutes?
Yeah, here, I'll show you right now. So Jeremy, we're starting at the home screen on the QM data box. And we're going to start by pressing the system button, which is button number 9, and that's going to bring us into the main menu. The very first option is measuring conditions. All I have to do here is press 1 or enter, and it will take me into the measuring conditions menu. The very first option here is for semi-floating. So again, hit 1 or enter. And now I have the option to turn that to X. Currently it's off, that's why it's selected for X. If I use my up arrow, I can move it to the circle, which will turn it on once I press the enter key. I can press 0 to exit out of my measuring conditions menu, and 0 again to exit out of my main menu. So now the semi-float is on. You currently don't hear the compressor running, and it's currently not active. It's only going to be active when you're measuring. So after I hit a measurement function key to begin a measurement, it'll turn on as semi-floating. And it's really only going to be beneficial for you here if you're using sweeping features. Features like you're measuring a radii or an arc, maybe doing a flatness. All right, you ready to see it in action?
Yes, sir.
Let's do it. So here's an example of a very large workpiece that we may need to measure a peak point on, but I don't want to move the part to sweep to find that peak point.
Right.
On the QM data, I'm going to press the option to measure a peak point. I'm going to select option number 1 because I'm doing this on an internal diameter. Now it's locating a scanning now. You can hear the compressor running. So the linear height is actually floating on a controlled pocket of air right now. So what I can do is I can move the linear height very easily. Scan and sweep the part, and when it's done, it will find a peak point.
Great, Drew. So we're able to use the gauge to measure very accurately and much more easily.
Exactly, and it's the same accuracy as if you were not using the semi-float option at all.
Well, great, Drew. That seems like a very easy and accurate way to measure large parts without having to move them around.
Exactly, and it's going to maintain the same accuracy as if you weren't using the semi-float option at all.
Excellent, excellent. Drew, once again, thanks for your time and showing us better ways to use linear height.
My pleasure. Thank you for your time as well. If you have any suggestions for future tool tips, please leave them in the comments below. If you have any questions, please feel free to give us a holler at 888-MITUTOYO or visit us online at www.mitutoyo.com.